हाँ बताइए, देयर इज नो प्रॉब्लम। आप
नहीं सर, वी कैन स्टार्ट नाउ, नो प्रॉब्लम,
वी कैन स्टार्ट।
यस सर।
ओके, ऑल द चिल्ड्रन आर ऑनलाइन।
यस सर।
ओके, फर्स्टली लेट मी इंट्रोड्यूस माय सेल्फ। आई एम ग्रुप कैप्टन निर्माल्या दास गुप्ता। फर्स्टली कॉम्प्लीमेंट ऑल द स्टूडेंट ऑफ विद्या अकेडमी got bright aspirations and are looking forward to look up to their lives in future, joining or becoming an engineer or a doctor or a officer in the armed forces, and wish you all the best. I will start my today's talk. It is a generic talk. You can I will give you an introduction about myself. Thereafter I'll tell you what all I have learned, the process of my journey for the last 47 years of my life. Now, I was born in October 1973 in a place called Jabalpur, which is in Madhya Pradesh. And I was the youngest sibling of three of the children of my parents. I have two elder sisters. One is a doctor, one is a MBA. And I became a pilot in the Indian Air Force, and here I am talking to you. When I started my journey in my school days, I was a person who was good in sports, and I have actually represented Madhya Pradesh in table tennis nationals. Almost made a career out of my table tennis career, and I almost got a job in State Bank of India in my class 10, after, because I was MP number 2 for 3 years in 87. So, but my father told me that, okay, look, you are okay in studies, so decide karo what you want to do. So I gave up the career of sports and chose a thorough profession, which was, I started preparing for JEE, that is IIT JEE that time, and made my best efforts. I took brilliant tutorial tuitions classes and Agarwal classes both together. I did pretty all right. However, I couldn't make the grade in IIT. I gave up my sports career totally and focused totally on studies. But that 2 years, although I didn't clear IIT, but those 2 years or 3 years of studies for IIT actually helped me clear the exam for National Defense Academy. I also cleared state engineering entrance, but I chose NDA over other careers because NDA was much more, what do you call it, a career with a charm. During my school days, I learned very important thing in my life. One very important thing which I learned in my life was, I used to be very focused, very sincere, and actually I was one of the boring kids. My friends used to make fun of me, saying, "तू कितना bore है, कुछ करता नहीं है." So I said, "ये 2 साल पढ़ लेते हैं, उसके बाद जितना मस्ती करना है करेंगे." And that's good. मेरा theory has always worked, and I keep telling my daughter the same thing: that work for these 2 to 3 years, make a career of your life, make out something of your life, and thereafter you can have all the fun in the world. And incidentally, most of my friends who were those the musty course are struggling little bit too till date. Some of them are still struggling. So the theory of working for these 2 to 3 years very hard and making a career out of what you have is very important. This was my first of my lessons in life. Once I joined NDA, after I joined NDA, initially I was in a state of shock, because coming from a civilian background with no input. Once I reached NDA, we realized that it was too tough. And every day it was only ragda, ragda, ragda. Half of the time it was punishments. Padhai to tha nahi jada, because padhai IIT-ically itna kar rakha tha, je aata tha most of the things. But those first 1 to 2 months were really tough in India. In fact, just to give an example, on the third day of our semester one, they made us run. The squadron, the seniors made us run a distance of more than 30 kilometers. And they did it because of by fear. We were all from various backgrounds. Some were Sainik school guys, some were military school, some were RIMC. But most of the other guys like us, me, were civilians who had never seen the back side of Fauj. When we were told, okay, do 30 kilometers. It was shocking. What do you mean by 30 kilometers? I've never seen 30 kilometers. And the 30 kilometers is not jogging, it is running. You're actually running for your life. We completed the route, incidentally, on the third day of NDA. And believe me, one second lesson of my life, which I learned from that incident, is that nothing is impossible. It is all here. If you decide to do something, it is here and you will achieve it. So, most important part is you must continue working hard in order to achieve what you want to do. And your hard work will be defined by your mind and nothing else. If you decide ye karna hai, to karna hai. This was the second important lesson I learned of my life when I joined NDA. One of the most important things. NDA life was very tough. And the training, we used to hate each day. Every day we used to hate getting up at 4 o'clock in the morning, going to clearing our toilets and going for work at 5:15 to 5:30. We were off for our PT or drill or anything. But each and every day we used to regret kahan aa gaye. But believe me, now after we have become officers and we are living life, the lessons what we learned because of that discipline, self-discipline and the thought process what NDA teaches you. I thank each and every day. And believe me, my parents, my wife, my daughter, they laugh at us when we friends meet after a long time. The only topic of discussion is NDA mein kya hua. And they are fed up of it to some extent. So that is what is your alma mater, actually, you can say. That is my alma mater. So these are the lessons we learned out of NDA. Okay. After completion of my NDA training, I got commissioned into the Indian Air Force as a fighter pilot. And also my initial rank was pilot officer. Pilot officer rank, aap log mein suna hi nahi hoga, because pilot officer rank, we were the last of the pilot officers. After our course, pilot officer rank was abolished. Because aaj ki date mein first rank in Air Force is flying officer. So we were the last of the pilot officers. And our promotion used to come once we used to finish our MiG operational flying training. So it was a very funny incident that when we reached a station in 98, we were still pilot officers and the entire Air Force was flying officers. So we used to call everybody sir. Then we realized 90% of them were junior to us and got commissioned much later. We were the last of the pilot officers of the Indian Air Force. Okay. However, once we finished my flying training, firstly, it was a MiG-21. Incidentally, I'm one of the few guys in my batch. And in fact, I was one of the youngest guys to have participated in Kargil operations. Not directly in Kargil, but I was a fully operational pilot by the time Kargil happened. And I have participated in Kargil in the Rajasthan sector. Because Indian Air Force was at war. That was my first exposure to Air Force operational flying. During the course of my career in the Indian Air Force, I became a qualified flying instructor. Subsequently, I became aware, I was training ab initio pilots as a flying instructor. During that process, I learned how to teach a person who's 21, 22 years old. And believe me, they behave like children. They behave like absolutely young children because flying is something which is not normal for you, which is not normal to human nature. So during my tenure as a flying instructor, this was one of the biggest exposures that, okay, the 21-year-old guy can become a child of 5-year-old. So how you handle them? That's what I learned. After finishing my pure qualified flying instructor's tenure, I did my experimental test pilot's course. Now, just to explain you, what is the experimental test pilot's course? Experimental test pilot is a course which is considered one of the toughest courses in the world. It, in India, we have only five to six test pilots coming out every year. And just to tell you who the test pilot, you heard of Rakesh Sharma, I suppose. Wing Commander Rakesh Sharma, the first Indian in space. He was also a test pilot. So he was also a test pilot. So during the course, we undergo very strenuous training in flying, as well as we fly various different aeroplanes. And we train, basically, we almost do a MSc in fluid dynamics and instrumentations. So my dream of doing kind of engineering or working on a new subject was fulfilled while doing this course. Because experimental test pilot, you make and design new systems. You work on new systems, which is when a new aircraft is made, say an aircraft is first time made, who's the first guy who flies that aircraft is an experimental test pilot. So that is the importance of becoming an experimental test pilot. Now, having done my test pilot's course, I thereafter got an opportunity, which was one of the greatest opportunities any fighter pilot can get. I was a part of the selection of Rafale. You must have heard of the Rafale, which we have bought recently. So Air Commodore Sanjay Chauhan, late Air Commodore Sanjay Chauhan and self, we were the first two people to have flown Rafale and selected it for India. And this was a selection which was done after flying six of the best aircrafts in the world. F-16, F-18, Eurofighter, Gripen, MiG-35, and that's it. And the Rafale, obviously. So out of the six aircraft, we chose Rafale. So becoming a TP was important. Getting this exposure was a boon. And incidentally, since then, I'm qualified on 32 different aeroplanes in India and abroad. And actually qualified when I mean, I have flown as a captain. I'm qualified to fly them from the front seat. It's one of the rare exposures you get. Okay, now that was about me. Coming to present situation, I am presently the chief test pilot in HAL Nasik and responsible for clearing all the Sukhois and the previously the MiG-21s and the MiG-29s. The Russian fleet of Indian Air Force flies under me. So that is my present job. And I sit in the same chair, which was in 94, chair was shared by Wing Commander Rakesh Sharma. So that is about me. Now, just to give you an insight into what all I have learned, some of the features, some of the points which I felt relevant, which you should know, I'll narrate a small incident which happened in NDA when we joined it. What happened was on the first, within the first week, we realized that when you join as NDA as a first-timer, you are actually nobody. Your identity is not there. So you're treated like you are a kachra, literally like kachra. Mm. So few of us were asked by one of the division, the DS, he asked us, what are the problems you have? One of the days. So one of my batchmates, he was, sir, in the evening, the tea and snacks which come, we don't get anything. All the seniors, they get it. They eat, they take, they're, everybody is supposed to get one biscuit, but some of the seniors take three, four biscuits. And by the time we reach, our turn comes, we don't get anything. So the divisional officer said, okay, what else? Who else has got any problems? So, few of us, we complained, gave small complaints. the guys who were from Sainik School and RIMC, they were aware of what we were getting into. They were continuously telling us, yeah, boss, keep quiet, keep quiet. But we were from civilian background, had no exposure, and we continued cribbing. And my batchmate who was there, he was a big crib master, he continued cribbing about small, 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 small things. Finally, the division officer said, okay, fine, we'll see what can be done about it. In the evening, when we were in our squadron, we see the same divisional officer coming to the unit, to the squadron. And he called all the senior most batch. And he actually bajawed the senior most guys. He made them do front roll, back roll, Maharaja, various things. And they were almost bleeding from all places. And then he made the squadron, he called the squadron, and then told the seniors, why did you get this? You know, because you can't even look after your youngsters. They are cribbing for small things in life. They're cribbing for things like biscuits. So this is what you're manufacturing in your squadron. That day we got a message that, okay, boss, small things, don't sweat about small things. Think about the big, larger picture in life. Choti-choti failures se kuch nahi hota hai. Choti-choti miss out se kuch nahi hoga. That was the first lesson I learned in India. The second lesson was, we all do that at home. We get up in the morning, get up from the bed and go out. Finally, my mom, your mom or your sister, somebody comes and clear, or your father, somebody comes and makes the bed for you. In India, you have to get up and make the bed. The first thing is you make the bed for yourself. Why is it important? It is important, reason being, you may have had a good day or a bad day. Say you have had the worst day of your life. But at the night, at the end of the day, when you come back to your room, if you see a well-made bed, you will feel good about it. And you will sleep with the hope that maybe tomorrow is a better day. So that is the second most important lesson of our lives, of my life. That when you get up in the morning, make your bed. It's a small thing, but it matters a lot. The next thing is, never be afraid of failures. Failures only make you tough. You may fail 100 times, but the 101st time, you will be successful and it will help you out. I have seen enough failures. I gave you first thing. I did not get through in IIT, but good, I got through in NDA. Maybe I wouldn't have done as well in IIT what I've done now. And in Air Force, during my stay or stint in with the Indian Air Force, I was one of the first guys to get my day ops or operational status. But still, I again lost out a lot in between. But when I got my dues, I lived the dream of any fighter pilot, which I already told you that I flew one of the best aircrafts in the world. So whatever due to you will come to you. Don't get disheartened. Continue working. If you get a failure, don't get disheartened. Continue working hard. Things will happen. Good things happen to good people. It is very important to remember this. And lastly, remember, life is not a 100-meter dash. It's a marathon. It's slow and steady wins the race. Sabke liye applicable. It is applicable to each and everyone in every phase of life. With this, I have conveyed what I wanted to convey. In case you all want to ask me anything about life in the armed forces or life at NDA or the way you want to get into Air Force or anything else, be it any question, I am here to answer you guys. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Lot of thanks. Really, मैं इतना खुश हूं आपको देखकर कि मुझे समझ भी नहीं आ रहा मैं आपसे क्या बोलूं. Really, बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद. You are great person. और मुझे इस बात का फक्र है कि आपने मेरे लिए, हमारे बच्चों के लिए इतना वक्त दिया सर. Really, lot of thanks, sir.
No, you are always welcome. If anybody wants to ask me anything, please, you are welcome.
I'm here only.
Just tell you, call out your name.
आपका नाम क्या है और क्वेश्चन क्या है बोलिए।
सर नचिकेत मेंदर सर, माय नेम इज नचिकेत मेंदर सर, हमें एग्जाम्स के पहले स्टडीज और क्या करना है सर, प्रिपरेशंस।
ये एनडीए के लिए पूछ रहा?
यस।
एनडीए के लिए सी आपको सबसे इम्पोर्टेंट है, आपको फिजिकली थोड़ा सा एक्टिव रहना पड़ेगा, बिकॉज जनरल क्या होता है दैट वी टेंड टू कंटिन्यूअस स्टडीज के चक्कर में हमको थोड़ा भागने का, खेलने का, कूदने का टाइम नहीं मिलता है। सो यू हैव टू टेक आउट टाइम सो एज टू कीप योरसेल्फ फिट। सेकेंड थिंग इज पढ़ाई के लिए जो करना पड़ता है, सबसे इम्पोर्टेंट इज न्यूज़पेपर पढ़ना शुरू करो रोज फॉर योर जनरल नॉलेज। न्यूज़पेपर रोज पढ़िए फॉर योर जनरल नॉलेज पेपर। इंग्लिश इफ योर आपको अगर इंग्लिश सही है, या इफ यू फील दैट यू आर नॉट वेरी कॉन्फिडेंट इन इंग्लिश, देन रीड सम बुक्स ऑन इंग्लिश, और इफ यू रीड द न्यूज़पेपर लाउडली आपका स्पोकन इंग्लिश इंप्रूव हो जाएगा। इंग्लिश इज इम्पॉर्टेंट बिकॉज SSB इंटरव्यू के टाइम पे दे डू आस्क क्वेश्चंस विच आर दे चेक हाउ कंफर्टेबल यू आर इन इंग्लिश। इट्स नॉट दैट आपका इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, बट इट हैज गॉट एडिक्वेट इम्पॉर्टेंस। सेकेंड थिंग इज आपका पढ़ाई के लिए वॉट यू आर इफ यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर यू आर इन विच क्लास नचिकेत, यू आर इन विच क्लास? हेलो,
आई थिंक सर 9th क्लास।
9th
सर,
6th क्लास।
ओह, 6th क्लास, 6th क्लास इज वेरी
गुड। 7th क्लास सर,
7th क्लास।
कंप्लीटेड 6th क्लास।
ओके, कंप्लीटेड 6th क्लास, यू आर इन 7th क्लास। सो आपको क्या करने की जरूरत है, आपको न्यूज़पेपर पढ़ना की आदत डालो, रेगुलर न्यूज़पेपर पढ़ो, रेगुलर इंग्लिश में बात करके आपका इंग्लिश, स्पोकन इंग्लिश को इम्प्रूव कर सकते हो इफ यू हैव अ प्रॉब्लम। मैथ्स इज इम्पॉर्टेंट, मैथ्स विल कम एज अ सेपरेट पेपर। मैथ्स में लॉजिक बेस्ड आंसर्स बहुत आते हैं, वो आप कर सकते हो। CSR हमारे टाइम पे CSR होता था सर, अभी सर विल बी एबल टू टेल यू, आई एम एटलीस्ट 10 जनरेशन सीनियर, इनफैक्ट आई एम 20 ईयर सीनियर टू योर सर, तो आपको आपको सर लेटेस्ट ज्यादा अच्छा बता पाएंगे। बट बेसिकली आप अगर इंग्लिश और स्पोकन इंग्लिश, जनरल नॉलेज इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज दे आस्क यू लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स इन द SSB, एंड सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट चीज व्हाट दे ट्राई एंड लुक एट इज द टेम्परामेंट ऑफ द पर्सन। टेम्परामेंट मीन्स, व्हेन आई से टेम्परामेंट मतलब आपका नेचर कैसा है, आप छोटी चीजों से घबरा रहे हो, नहीं घबरा रहे हो, बहुत अच्छी बात है। ये SSB के टाइम पे जज करते हैं।
निहाल क्या क्वेश्चन है बेटा, पूछो, अपना नाम बताओ और अपना क्वेश्चन पूछो।
सर आई एम निहाल मेहरोलिया। सर आई वांटेड टू आस्क यू वेदर डज इट मैटर इन NDA दैट वी आर फ्रॉम स्टेट बोर्ड और वी आर फ्रॉम CBSE बोर्ड।
नो, यू आर इन व्हिच क्लास?
11th सर, आई एम 11th मूविंग।
11th, ओके, सो एब्सोल्युटली नो इश्यू, आई एम फ्रॉम MP बोर्ड यार। हमारा सिलेबस यूज्ड टू बी टोटली डिफरेंट एज कम्पेयर टू CBSE। इफ यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर विच एग्जाम एग्जैक्टली?
सर फॉर NDA।
ओके, इफ यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर NDA, यू जस्ट कंसंट्रेट ऑन योर 11th का रिजल्ट, शुड बी गुड। 11th एंड 12th रिजल्ट कंसंट्रेट करो, पैरेलली वर्क ऑन योर मैथ्स। पेपर्स, इनिशियल पेपर्स आर नॉट टफ, एंड यू हैव टू डू लिटिल हैंड आई कोऑर्डिनेशन एक्सरसाइजेस, फॉर विच सारा दिन मोबाइल नहीं देखना है। मोबाइल रिड्यूसेस योर हैंड आई कोऑर्डिनेशन, रिमेंबर दैट। मोबाइल एक्सेस, मोबाइल यूजेज रिड्यूसेस योर हैंड आई कोऑर्डिनेशन। अनफॉर्चुनेटली कोविड के सिचुएशन में चिल्ड्रन एंड एवरीबडी इज फिक्स्ड ऑन मोबाइल्स, विच इज नॉट वेरी गुड फॉर NDA। If and aapko which stream do you want to join, army, air force, navy?
Sir, army.
Army, okay. Still you need very good coordination of hand eye, and what they check is your attitude and temperament, which I told to Nachiket just now. So you prepare, you need to read newspapers to keep yourself current with the whatever is going on in the present situation, and mathematics is important, plus जनरल इंग्लिश एंड ऑल दो जनरल जो लैंग्वेज, जनरल पेपर जो होता है आप लोगों का, That I'm sure sir will be able to give you a little better insight.
Avinav Patil, apna naam bataiye aur apna question boliye.
Sir, with what mindset we should study for big exams such as competitive and school exams?
You're in which class?
9th.
Okay. Which exam are you talking of?
Sir, means competitive exams, NTSC, NDA.
You asked only NDA, not?
ठीक है, नहीं कोई बात नहीं. देखो अभिनव, देखो सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट चीज है आपको फोकस होना चाहिए. मेहनत करोगे कोई भी चीज मिलेगा. मेहनत ये नहीं जो कुछ सब ये भी सब इकट्ठा कर लिया, 10 चीजें इकट्ठा कर ली, पढ़ते रहे. जो भी पढ़ रहे हो आप, जो मैंने सीखा है, आई हैव नेवर स्टडीड, मे बी वंस आई हैव रिवाइज, सेकेंड टाइम थर्ड टाइम मैंने जिंदगी में कोई भी सब्जेक्ट में कोई भी पेज का दोबारा विजिट नहीं किया मैंने. इवन टूडे आई कैन टीच माई डॉटर बिकॉज आई हैव whatever I used to study, I used to quietly, once I used to study, I used to go sit quietly and think about it and apply it correctly. Kal ke din sabse important cheez which will help you is you are avo three idiots picture dekha hai? Huh?
Yes sir.
Usme kya dialogue kya hai? Sabse important dialogue picture ka, beta kabil bano, success jhak maar ke piche aayegi, hai na? So just remember this part. Whatever you study, revisit it, quietly sit, think about what you studied. You will never forget it. Because when you do that, you are writing that answers in your mind. And once you've written those answers in your mind, nobody can erase them. I'll give you an example. This is for general everybody. Point, whatever I have studied till date in because of the way I used to study, when we went for evaluation for all of across the globe, where people were much more learned, the technology is way beyond what we have seen in India. It was just that type of study which helped me, nothing else. Yeah. And if you do that, it helps you, believe me.
Yeah.
Okay, next.
Sir, actually I wanted to tell you that recently I have cleared the NTSC exam, that is National Talent Search Examination, and I have bagged the first position in all over Nashik and 16th position in Maharashtra.
Congratulations.
Thank you, sir. And sir, there is also one institute in Aurangabad, that is SPI. So I have cleared that examination also. And day after tomorrow is my interview for SPI. So sir, when I got to know that SPI is state board, so I was in a dilemma whether to join it or not. So that was that I wanted to ask you.
I had a coursemate from SPI and he was one of the best guys with me, Desai. Rajesh Desai and his brother, both were from SPI. So there's absolutely no issues. There's nothing, a state board, CBSC, yes, you got to put in little more effort. Maybe from state board side because the books may be different, but it doesn't make any difference. As far as I know, we had enough number of students from SPI. In fact, my coursemate is there, Rajesh Desai, and one more, his brother's name I'm forgetting because he was not in my squad. And he was a brilliant guy.
Thank you so much, sir.
Nihal beta.
Yes, sir.
प्लीज कॉन्टैक्ट मेरे से भी करो, मैं आपको और बेहतर सजेस्ट करूंगा, ठीक है ना? बेहतर सर ने बताया है, उसके अलावा भी कुछ चीजें होंगी, तो आप मेरा ये नंबर है, आप कॉन्टैक्ट करो, ठीक है ना? व्हाट एवर वी कैन
हेल्प, यस सर, ओके सर,
ठीक है ना? और सर से हम हमेशा मुलाकात कराते रहेंगे, टेंशन ना लो.
यस सर.
एनी स्टूडेंट्स, कोई बच्चा, एनी स्टूडेंट्स, किसी बच्चे को कुछ पूछना है सर से? किसी बच्चे को कुछ पूछना है सर से?
हेलो सर.
हाँ, नाम बताइए.
सर, माय नेम इज मोहित. सर, मुझे ये पूछना था कि एनडीए के जो कैंडिडेट, वो अपना क्वालिटी टाइम कैसे यूज कर सकते हैं?
मींस एनडीए की क्वालिटी, मींस यू क्लियर्ड एनडीए?
नो सर, मतलब अभी हम एनडीए में जाने वाले, सो हमें अपना क्वालिटी टाइम कैसे यूज करना चाहिए?
क्वालिटी टाइम मींस अच्छा पढ़ाई कैसे करना चाहिए आप?
यस सर, यस सर।
यार एनडीए का जो पेपर होता है ना, जितना हमारे टाइम पे होता था, इट इज वेरी 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 सिंपल पेपर एज कम्पेयर टू जेईई पेपर, इफ यू कंपेयर इट विद जेईई पेपर। बट इट हैज गॉट लॉट ऑफ एप्लीकेशन ओरिएंटेड क्वेश्चंस, जो एप्लीकेशन वाले क्वेश्चंस होते हैं, लॉजिक वाले क्वेश्चंस होते हैं, एंड सिंपल लॉजिक होता है वो। बेसिकली आपको एनडीए में बहुत ब्रिलियंट बंदा नहीं चाहिए, एनडीए नीड्स एवरेज टू एवरेज प्लस किड्स, बट देयर नीड टू बी अ फोकस, दे हैव टू बी फोकस्ड, दे हैव टू बी फोकस्ड एंड दे नो, दे नीड टू नो ये उसको जो चीज आता है वो अच्छे से आता है। तो एनडीए का जो पेपर है, मैंने जैसे पहले भी बताया, न्यूज़पेपर पढ़ो आप करंट अफेयर्स के लिए, रेगुलर न्यूज़पेपर पढ़ो, स्पोकन इंग्लिश बढ़ेगा, इम्प्रूव होगा अगर आप उसको इंग्लिश न्यूज़पेपर पढ़ना, उसको बोल बोल के पढ़ोगे तो आपका स्पोकन इंग्लिश इम्प्रूव होगा। और अपने हैंड आई कोऑर्डिनेशन के लिए कोई गेम खेलो, मे बी सम रैकेट गेम, कोई रैकेट गेम खेलो या फुटबॉल खेलो, दोज थिंग्स विल ऑलवेज हेल्प यू इन एनडीए सिलेक्शन। एंड मे बी सी एस आर अगर है, या तो सर बताएंगे आपको वॉट आर द लेटेस्ट बुक्स। हमारे टाइम पे कॉम्पिटिशन सक्सेस रिव्यू होता था जिसमें प्रैक्टिस लॉजिक वाले आंसर क्वेश्चन आंसर आते थे, दे वर वेरी गुड। आई डोंट नो वेदर दे आर स्टिल देयर और नॉट, दैट यू कैन चेक विद सर, सर विल बी एबल टू गाइड यू बेटर ऑन दैट।
साई बेटा नाम बताओ और क्वेश्चन पूछो जल्दी, टाइम कम है अब।
सर माय नेम इज साई, आई एम इन क्लास 7, व्हाट शुड आई डू फॉर गोइंग फॉर एनडीए?
फर्स्टली यू नीड टू, या वेरी गुड, यू शुड रिमेन मोटिवेटेड टू गो टू एनडीए, यू शुड रिमेन फिजिकली एक्टिव, यू शुड व्हाटएवर यू आर स्टडी उसको समझ के पढ़ना है, यू शुडंट मग अप।
ओके सर।
ओके, एंड what you need to start reading newspapers, get yourself more aware of the world outside, improve your hand eye coordination as I covered, play some games which need you to control your hand, legs, eyes, movements, that will help you in your selection process, kyunki wahan par there are a lot of physical activities which are checked after your written is over.
Okay,
anything?
Sir, thank you sir.
Any student
sir, my name is, hello sir, good evening sir. My name is Prathamesh Chatur sir.
Okay
sir, can I speak into Hindi?
Haan please yaar.
Sir agar maths mein humne jo zyada weightage ke liye sa ne us pe zyada focus karke india ki taiyari ki to chal sakta hai kya?
Maths mein focus karke,
मैथ्स में मतलब बाकी सब्जेक्ट पर भी और मैथ्स में जो ज्यादा वेटेज के लेसन है उन पे ही ज्यादा।
देखो अगर आपका रिजल्ट अच्छा नहीं आएगा ना 11th 12th में, तो एनडीए में प्रॉब्लम आएगा आपके मेरिट लिस्ट में, अगर आप एनडीए पास भी होगे तो। सो योर 12th, आपका 12th का रिजल्ट मैटर करता है, सो आपको सारे सब्जेक्ट्स का वेटेज सेम रखना चाहिए मेरे हिसाब से। यस, आपको मैथ्स ज्यादा, मैथ्स में भी आपको इतना कुछ टफ नहीं आता है पेपर, आपको सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट चीज जो ध्यान रखना है एनडीए के लिए इस, आपको लॉजिक बेस्ड आंसर्स आना चाहिए।
yes,
जो yes, जो क्या पजल्स जो होते हैं, आई वुड से पजल बेस्ड क्वेश्चंस के आंसर्स, दे आर मोर उस तरह के क्वेश्चंस होते हैं एंड बहुत सिंपल एप्लीकेशन ओरिएंटेड क्वेश्चंस होते हैं, दे आर नॉट डिफिकल्ट। तो मैथ्स का पेपर भी आपको ऐसा कोई स्पेसिफिक, अगर आप स्कूल की अच्छे से पढ़ाई कर लोगे इट इज एडिक्वेट मेरे हिसाब से। बट आपको जीके का जो पेपर होता है दूसरा पेपर, उसके लिए आपको तैयारी करनी ज्यादा जरूरी है मेरे हिसाब से, क्योंकि आज की जनरेशन ज्यादातर बच्चे आर यूज टू सीइंग रीडिंग थिंग्स ऑन मोबाइल, मतलब आप मोबाइल में ज्यादा इंटरेस्टेड रहते हैं तो आपको काफी चीजें मिस आउट हो जाता है जो क्या हो रहा है दुनिया में, वो ज्यादा जरूरी है। ठीक है,
ओके सर, थैंक यू सर,
यू वेलकम।
Any student want to ask?
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Sir, I'm Tejas Nagre.
Sir, okay.
My question is, as per you, what are the qualities one must have to be an fighter pilot?
Pardon? Can you speak a little louder?
Sir, as per you, what all are the qualities one must have to be an fighter pilot?
Fighter pilot?
Yes, sir.
You have to think you are a fighter pilot. Sabse important cheez hai. You have to think in your mind and remember fighter pilot, this population of fighter pilots in the world are 0.01. So if you think that you are in the one of the best guys in the world, you will become a fighter pilot. I'm just joking. You have to have a very positive attitude and be open to whatever you get. And yes, सबसे important चीज है आपको fighter pilot के never say die attitude. You can never give up. सबसे important चीज जो है छोड़ना नहीं है. छोड़ दिया तो बंदा मर जाएगा, simple. क्योंकि फौज में सबसे बड़ा difference यही है, fighter pilot, एयरफोर्स में फाइटर पायलट ही लड़ाई करने जाता है, बाकी कोई ब्रांच लड़ाई नहीं करने जाता है. जैसे आर्मी में सोल्जर्स जाते हैं, ऑफिसर्स जाते हैं, वेरियस टाइप वेरियस ब्रांचेस, दे ऑल गो टू वॉर. नेवी में पूरा शिप जाता है लड़ने, एयरफोर्स में सिर्फ फाइटर पायलट जाता है लड़ने. तो वो एटीट्यूड आना जरूरी है, जे आई एम गुड एंड यू हैव टू प्रूव टू बी गुड. दैट इज वॉट इज नीडेड टू बी ए फाइटर पायलट. And you should, fighter pilot is one who, good fighter pilot is one whom banda bole je war, if I want to go to war, I want to go with him. Nobody else. He will get me back. So this is what the attitude you need to have to become a fighter pilot. And a good one. There are a lot of fighter pilots. But sir, good fighter pilots, you need to have this.
Time over ho gaya sir. Shayad kat jayega. Iske liye bahut bahut dhanyawad. Aur main chahunga ki खुलेगा तो आप फिजिकली भी हमारे बच्चों को आए और एक बार. थैंक यू सर.
थैंक यू
लॉट ऑफ. थैंक यू सर. रियली
थैंक यू. ऑल द बेस्ट. ऑल द बेस्ट टू ऑल ऑफ यू. गॉड ब्लेस यू.
थैंक यू सर.
थैंक यू सर.
थैंक यू सर.
वेलकम.